Yamauchi said he's gonna go drinking in that Monji restaurant. You'll help me investigate undercover, right? So what are you gonna do? We listen to Ryuji's request. Alright, I'll be counting on you.
Sure.
A waterfront district surrounded by canals, famous for its monjiaki. Nostalgic Japanese flavor. Tsukimishi's famous monjiaki will remind you of the good old days.
Alright.
You have information about a new hangout spot, Tsukishima Monja. You can also invite people who may enjoy eating monjiaki to hang out with you there.
Well, I did say I'd spy on him a long time ago, so might as well now.
The teacher is with him and shit on me too. Sorry, but I'm gonna be hiding in the bathroom if you need me. Damn it, Ryuji! Please, Retro! Fine, but I'm playing Pokemon! Just leave your phone on so I can hear what they're saying. Bollocks! Alright. Wow, you can really hold your liquor, Yamauchi. I've had some experience. Back in my college days, we'd rent a yacht for the weekend and have massive parties. I must say, though, the sake's been tasting particularly sweet lately. No surprise there. Things have been much calmer without Kamoshida. Those were some real dark times with Shujin, though, huh? But now that he's gone, you finally get the chance you deserve, Yamauchi.
Don't flatter me. He had his strength, sure, but because of him, our volleyball team will be forever scarred. The only real option now is to abandon it completely.
There has to be a way to bring Shujin back into the limelight, though that's where I come in. You mean with the track team, right?
The students who went through so much hardship under Kamoshida rise again with a caring new advisor. It'll be the rebirth of a team that found themselves in the depths of despair.
Public will love it! It's amazing.
Despite my lack of track and field knowledge, I'll form a tight bond with the students. I'll be the protagonist of my very own tearjerker. And of course, all the praise for reviving them will go to me, their incredible, loving teacher. I'll have to hire a great coach if I want to pull this off, though.
You're gonna pretend to coach them while someone else does all the legwork? Amazing, Yamauchi!
Such stunning achievements will look great when it comes time to hand out the bonuses. But I'm not going to stop there, either. I'll publish books, give motivational speeches.
What about all the troublemakers on the team? I've heard that Nakaoka kid's kinda bad.
Nakaoka? Oh, you mean the one who asked them to bring the pre-Kamoshida coach back?
Don't worry, I've already taken care of him.
There. There's this other boy in the track team, Takeishi. Doesn't really excel in much of anything. Well, I said I would make him the next captain if he could get rid of that troublemaker Nakaoka. I might have mentioned something about how Nakaoka was working with Kamoshida too.
Totally, of course, don't want anything to come back.
And what ended up happening? Apparently, Takeishi chased him away. The plan worked precisely and perfectly. And the best part is, not only are Takeishi's parents loaded, but his mother's the president of the PTA.
I see, he'd make a great pawn!
Perhaps, but nothing like him could ever captain a successful championship-winning team.
He may have to have an unfortunate accident at a practice one day.
But until then, he can show the others the value of obedience.
You're incredible! That fucking asshole! If we don't do something quick, Yamauchi's gonna get rid of Takeishi too. God damn it!
Yeah, he's a scumbag and he sounded like it too.
So, should we change his heart? I mean, it'll be real quick, he's real shallow.
Real easy.
I really wanna.
But that'd probably just mess up the track team's comeback. And I don't wanna cause him any more problems. So they're just gonna have to descend the road.
Hey.
You know, track ain't a team sport.
At least sprinting wasn't.
Huh? You've got teammates, sure, but you're really just looking out for your own time. That's why I never thought about asking people for help or trying to solve our problems together as a team.
And again.
But I can't ignore the stuff they're going through right now. I mean, even though we had our own goals and shit, we were still running together. They suffered with me, gritted their teeth with me. Honestly, I think it was only because of them I was able to run as well. So I can't just go out and turn my back on them, you know? I know that ain't the coolest thing to say, but it's how I feel, right? I guess go, Ryuji.
Yeah, alright. Wait, yeah. Huh? Really? For real? Thanks, man. Yeah, you actually stand by your beliefs. You didn't just turn your back on the team because they turned their back on you. That takes confidence, and you should be proud of that. I feel like my bond with Ryuji is growing deeper. Okay, I should explain. Insta-skill is the infamous skill that Ryuji gets. Basically, if you're trying to grind, Ryuji is now your mortal enemy. And I enabled it. What it basically does is, if you're stronger than the Shadow is, and you ambush them, that's the key thing, it will instantly die. If you ambush it, it will just die. So you cannot grind by ambushing the enemy. So if you're trying to level, you can't. You really can't. So it kinda gets in the way for some people. For me, I quite like it because it means I don't have to fight every enemy that gets in our way, like the last dungeon with all those goddamn dogs. But a lot of people seem to hate it. But I like it, so it doesn't bother me.
Alright.
Your chariot of confidence has reached or increased the ranks of. You'll now have more experience from Arcana Burst when you use the personas of the chariot, Arcana. Ryuji can now use the insta-kill skill.
Wait.
Anyways, I'm starving. Let's eat some monja while we're here. Right now, all I've seen of this place is the goddamn toilet. Yeah, true. Thanks for hanging with me, man. No idea. No worries, mate. Monja's not bad. It's like an omelette, sort of, that you can fill with meat. Which I suppose is an omelette. Google it. It is actually quite good. I can't describe it, but it is quite good. Nice.
It's so hot.
And humid. I wish the rainy season would just end. By the way, June's almost over, right? Yeah, I think it ends tomorrow, right? We defeated Kaneshiro, so I guess we can rest easy for a while? So, what do you want to do today? Maybe something like take a trip to Mementos? No! We were there the other day! Stop bringing it up! No! Yep, I want to chill. I'm resting. Breaks are important. Breaks are very important. Everybody, to all my adoring fans, this is the reason why this series is going to be huge, by the way. I keep doing shit like this. But, to my adoring public, breaks are very important. Yes, it is great that you want to dedicate your time to what you love and your studies and your research and everything else. But remember, you're human too. You need some you time. Whether that's sitting down with a cup of coffee, a cup of tea, a good book, playing a game, listening to this very rant, you need some time that's just for you to do what you want. Otherwise, you're just gonna stress yourself out. The amount of people I've talked to recently that are all stressed over everything and anything, and it's all just because they either never took any time for themselves or they've left everything for the last minute. Just relax. We're all human. We're all there to help each other. You just need to remember, you're you. So, embrace it. So yes, breaks are very important. But we have those requests on the message board, so don't forget to answer them, okay? Yeah. And that being said, I've dealt with all the requests on the answer board so far, so we're good. Should probably talk to Mishima about that. Nah, I'll do it later. Mishima around. Don't see him. Okay, Mikoda, I'm reading the messages, but I'm not replying to you. What are you doing today, Rentoku-kun? I just finished up some student council work. I've had a lot on my mind, so I can't really concentrate. Let me know if anything comes up. I'll be at the school for a little while longer. Seems like Mikoda hasn't gone home yet. Wanna go hang out with her a bit? No. All I've done is hang out with Mikoda recently, so no. This is about my new piece, Desire. It was selected for the public exhibition. It's already on display there now. If it's alright with you, could we go see it together? Let my bond with Yusuke grow stronger soon. And we don't really hang out with him too often, so why not? So what you call? Will you spend time with Yusuke? Yeah, sure. Let's go. Thank you. It will actually be my first time going as well. I will send you the location of the art museum now. Let's meet up there and head in. Okay. God, it's way out of the way, isn't it? Ueno. Ueno. My best pronounced. A versatile area full of shopping and cultural establishments. Get cultured or not, many famous paintings and sculptures can be seen at the art museum. Okay, Yusuke, you should know I'm not the most well-cultured man. I don't know much about art at all. For instance, actually speaking of art,
Alright.
You now have information on a new hangout spot, Wayno Museum. I'll talk about this art thing later. You can also invite people who may enjoy art museums to hang out with you there. Away we go. I'll tell you my anecdote about art later. Try the music.
Indeed.
In addition to the exhibition aspect of the show, there's also the evaluation portion. What? How do you evaluate what? I believe my piece truly stands out amongst the sea of art here. Yeah, that is true. Oh, cool. The one on the right's really good. And yet nobody has come to see it. Perhaps they are so afraid of the truth held within that they dare not take a closer look. What's this supposed to be? There's a dark, almost sinister aura emanating from it. The title is Desire. See no desire here, though. Oh, I understand now. This area is for students. The artist lightly decided to paint this on a whim. Indeed, there is neither elegance nor emotion in this piece. Come, dear. There are much more detailed paintings over there. Come along. Don't worry about it. What do they know? There are only like a million. Ignore them. That's not to worry. I'm not bothered in the slightest. That was nothing more than a drivel of unrefined commoners. I needn't pay them any mind. As long as those who are in the know understand my work, I will be happy. This is...
What?
A knowledgeable patron has arrived. I would like your opinion, sir. What are your thoughts on this piece? I can see quite clearly why it was accepted into the exhibition. The technique is excellent. However, the composition as a whole is mediocre at best.
What'd you say?
How dare you? Wait, what do you mean mediocre? Fuck you, okay? Screw you. Are you the artist by chance? No, I'm a friend of the artist and you're an asshole. Screw you. The title is listed as Desire, but that idea is quite overused. Some even call it stale. If you want to paint an abstract work with such an old theme, you must inject some individuality into it. What? Take another look. Try to remove yourself from the artist's bias. Those brushstrokes are splendid given your age, but does this painting really tell you anything? It is empty, devoid of meaning. I suggest you take a more critical eye to your work in the future if you truly want to progress as an artist. My work is empty? Wait, what do you mean empty? What a dick! Screw that guy! No, it may be difficult to bear at times, but the beholder is entitled to their own opinion. No, he's a dick. He's just a dick.
Why?
But why? I put my heart and soul into this piece, captured the very essence of desire. It was supposed to lay bare the reality of this world. Perhaps he was right. It may be empty after all. These colors, these brushstrokes, they do not convey the true meaning of desire, only my conception of it. I haven't captured desire. Desire has captured me!
How could this be?
How could I have fooled myself into believing otherwise? Yusuke? Mate, you okay? It is as though I have been forsaken by the gods of art! This grave mistake shall be the end for me! But Yusuke, you're still breathing! There's always a take two! This is just the beginning, though. I can get stronger from here. Do not patronize me! I have no future in this field! Damn it, yes, guy! What is going to happen to me now? Without art, what will remain? I just fucked up all the words. Without art, what will remain of my being? Stand up, yes, guy! Stand strong! You can do it! What?
I see.
I must stand up, both literally and figuratively. Yeah? Failure and art go hand in hand. I cannot simply give up now. Still, being criticized by someone with such a keen eye is truly painful. Been there.
Okay.
But that is all the more reason I must break out of my slump. I must prove my ability to him. That's the spirit, but how the fuck are you gonna do that? I will start by painting After that, I will paint. Beyond which, I shall paint even more. That is the only way I will learn to capture the essence of emotion. After all, you can only accomplish so much in using logic to analyze the contents of the heart. I hope you allow me to continue my skill card services as well, Rintaro. I shall conquer this! Yeah! I have no idea what's going on, but yes, Yosuke. Yosuke? Yes, Yosuke, we will stand up to the art world and punch it in the face. But that guy was a dick. Okay? Yosuke seems especially motivated. Follow up. Chance to perform a follow up attack and Joker's attack does not down the enemy. Sweet.
Alright.
Your Emperor confidence increased to rank 3. You will now earn more experience from Arcana Burst when using Personas of the Emperor Arcana. Yusuke can now use follow up.
Let us return home.
Now then, let us head home. I wish to start anew. A slump, hmm? Right, I can finally tell my artist anecdote. Right, one of my lecturers... I'll deal with you in a minute, Hifumi. Right, actually, speaking of people I had to deal with, I had to talk to that fortune teller eventually. But yeah, one of my lecturers, who is a sound design student, he's graduated with sound and games and stuff. But anyway, so it's how sound bounces off walls, how you use it to build an ambiance, to build a scene, use the music to engross the player, make them feel like they're in the world. For instance, music right now is nice and chill because we're in a cafe. That idea. Anyway, one of his friends is a builder or something to that effect. So he was working in an art museum and he was fixing the floorboards in the museum. But what he was doing was he'd taken one of the boards up and he'd obviously stuck it back down, but it was a bit uneven. So he was trying to get it to set. I think it's set or like stick in place probably, but it was offset. You cannot see my hands, but I'm trying to make an offset sign. For instance, like, you see all the laminate floor that we're standing on? It's slightly raised compared to the wood. That idea. It's slightly higher than the other one. So what he did was he put the planks next to each other, so he put it in place. Obviously, it had that raised. So he went and got a cinder block, because obviously he's a builder, so he got a cinder block. He put two cinder blocks on top of it in a sort of T-shaped function, and then buggered off to have a cup of tea and figured, you know, come back half an hour. It fixed it, did that, came back. And because it was in an art exhibit, a bunch of entitled people came up and were looking at it, and you could just hear them mumbling to themselves, going, what do you think this piece shows? Is it an illusion of the mind as a whole? Is it about the creative society? And he's standing there with a cup of tea in one hand and a biscuit in the other, just thinking, it's two fucking cinder blocks. What the hell's wrong with you? So, see what I mean? People perceive things differently based on where it is. If he'd done the exact same thing in, say, I don't know, a university or a school, nobody would have bought that. They'd go, oh, it's construction, just left it alone. But because it was a museum, all the pompous idiots thought that it was some devout meaning of life. It was the cinder block. See what I mean? I just thought that was rather funny. People are idiots. Anyway, remember our deal. Speaking of idiots, now to be proven one. You can become my playing partner so that I can research new moves. I'd like to begin by teaching you the basics of Shogi. Would you like to play a match? I feel like my body Hifumi will grow stronger soon. You agreed to a deal with Hifumi, so be sure to accept our invitations until you gain our trust, okay? Okay, let's go. I'll be there. I'll be waiting at the church. On it. Deal with that fortune teller later. But yeah, I did find that rather amusing, that because it was an art museum.
I'll start.
They all thought it was some fancy schmancy artsy fartsy thing, and it was just two cinder blocks trying to put the wood back together, which is rather funny. Vanguard of my Togo Kingdom, go forth to the front line, trample upon them all! You think to protect yourself with that paltry defense? Ha 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 ha! It's useless. Awaken dragon, let your shadowy hellfire consume them all! Dark Inferno Rook! Ah, you're filming your voice is so intense that I just unfired again.
I will be better.
But the next time I get to record this in bulk. Not next episode, but like, next season. Seriously, Hifumi, your passion and devoid love of your pieces is shredding my soul apart. Anyway, can you hear the wailing and dire of dying soldiers echoing throughout the battlefield? Seriously, Hifumi, what the hell? With an incomplete, competent king, a soldier cannot show his true bravery. Time for you to suffer. Okay. At last, everything is in place. My right hand trembles as I release my full power.
Check.
I summon forth the forbidden move that shall bring forth your end. Ultimate Excalibur Attack!
Hey, Fumi, are you sure you're playing Shogi and not Yu-Gi-Oh? Because that screams Yu-Gi-Oh. Check. I did it again. What the fuck was that? Hey, Fumi. What was even that? How can I learn how to play Shogi if every move has a Chunibyo? Actually, I can learn a lot better how to play Shogi because every move has a Chunibyo thing tied to it. You're a friggin' genius! Of course I'm gonna learn more. I care more about Shogi if I can call my pieces instead of Pawn. Ultimate Dragon Slayer! Just sounds better. You know what I mean? I will pay more attention because it sounds cooler. I'm very childish. I did it again. Huh? It's an embarrassing habit I have. During a match, I tend to get very aggressive. It's as if I assume the role of a queen of a kingdom. Well, that's interesting! I like the attitude, Jane. You're very reserved normally. The attitude's quite nice. Huh? I myself kind of find it a bit... well... my father has told me to do image training exercises when I was younger to help me learn the rules. I gradually began to view the Shogi board as if it were my own kingdom. I had fun coming up with stories and strategies for my, subjects. However, I've heard that people make fun of me on the internet. Hifumi, people make fun of me on the... actually, people make fun of me in person. So, don't worry about it. Also, I give them plenty of ammunition to do so. Me and one of my friends, after a fair, told me he went as Ichiya. We just walked around the convention with him going, man, to every lass he could find. It was the best and dumbest con-going experience ever. Because if you don't get the inside joke, it's just weird. So, but if you do get the inside joke, watch Fairy Tail, it's amazing. So, both the show and the joke. So go ahead. I've heard people make fun of me on the internet. People make fun of me too, so don't worry about it. Why? Why would they care? People think I'm weird, or that I'm an otaku, or that I'm just plain crazy. Embrace those things, right? I mean, I can't blame them. Certainly, I think I'm weird too. Don't worry about them. What the fuck did I know? Screw them.
Yes.
Your positivity is, well, a welcome relief. I get that occasionally too.
If you look at everything negatively, it's just gonna bum you out. But if you look at everything in a sort of I'm rubber and you're glue perspective, any of the critiques or criticisms that isn't constructive, you can just bounce right off. Like, why should I care? Well, what makes you better than me? You're still human, you still have two legs, two arms, a head that's full of nonsense. What do you do? They're not any better than you. Sure, they act better, sure, they talk better, but they're not better. They're still people. They still came from roughly the same place, a man and a woman. And that's about it. So, what makes their opinion more or less relevant than yours? So, screw up. Simple as that. I may be able to learn more from our matches than I thought. I can sense a deep bond of trust between Hifumi and I.
Alright.
Your star confidence has increased the rank to. You and I, there were more experience from Arcana Burst when choosing personas of the Star Arcana. That will do for today. Okay. That's a good game. Well, there's something I wanted to mention. Yeah? Do you read weekly magazines? I used to. I used to be Top Gear. But I kind of stopped. I would like to read some of the Shonen Jump stuff, though, because apparently some of the writers that I quite like, I say writers, demo their new pieces before it become full series in them. What was the other one? The other one was like Dragon Weekly, or I think that was it, and that's where Datalive came from. So, yeah, weekly magazines aren't actually as full of crap as you think. Really depends on what you're reading. Yeah? Well, I'm doing a photo shoot for one. Really? Wait. What kind of photo shoot? Wait, you don't want it, right? You're like an idol, Falcon. So, when's it coming out? Why do you ask? Regardless, they haven't decided on a date yet, so I have yet to say the right thing for this laugh once. So, I mean, yep, not once. Oh well. I thought you'd be surprised if you saw it on the newsstand, so I wanted to let you know beforehand. In all honesty, I'm very reluctant to do it. Yeah? But maybe if I can draw more attention to Shogi, maybe the sport will become more popular. Yeah, that's true. If you draw more attention to it, the sport would get a bigger popularity and a bigger fan base, which would lead to a bigger budget. That's kind of what happened in my industry. I mean, games used to be tiny, and look at them now. They're pretty much the biggest industry on the planet, just after movies. Maybe fashion's a bit better too, but still. So I mean, it went from nothing, Space Invaders, to massive in about 20 years. So popularity is key. At least that's how I'm justifying it to myself. I have an interview scheduled for tonight as well, so let's end it here for today. Okay. I feel like playing Shogi with Fifumi has helped sharpen my knowledge too. You know, I kinda like Persona. It lets me bring up anything and everything.
Until next time.
It's a nice little background for us to talk. Me and myself and I. Because I have no views. Not like it really bothers me. I mean, if I cared what my viewer count was, I'd stream. I could stream, but no. I'd rather chill, relax, play games I like, talk. Even if I just get my ideas out there. Someone's bound to bite. Or just nod along. I'm happy. Besides, safe space, you know? Until our next match. Goodbye. I just like games that let you do that. I like action games because you have to be in the moment to do it. But it's always nice to play something that you have complete control over like this. For instance, a turn-based game, someone quoted me, well, not me, but someone quoted this to me the other day.
Hey!
Saying that they prefer turn-based games over action games because whichever type of game will the final boss wait for you to have a nap and wake up before attacking you again. You don't get that in shooters. They just shoot you. If you're asleep, they shoot you. That idea. Edit that out, please. Still dying though. But it's that idea. I like the idea of having games on as a conversation piece. They're on the background. If you were really interested in the game, you'd buy it and play it by now. Especially for one like this that's been out for so long. But if it's on and people are paying attention, then I'm quite happy with it. Anyway, I seem to have gone down a very strange rabbit hole and have ended up in some strange goal. Anyway, we were able to grab a seat, so why don't you read something until we get there? Now that you mention it, I did start reading Gallant Rogue a while ago, so let's go. Striking a pose of defiance with the tobacco pipe in hand, he truly looked like a great thief.
Wow!
Yoshikawa Goemon was a thief without peer, so he was a hero to the common people, huh?
Oh!
So you finished reading the Gallant Rogue? That splendid spirit that pays no mind to the bad guys is a true example of a gentleman thief. After reading this, I'm sure you'll have a better understanding of the chivalrous thief's courage.
Alright.
Rentor's guts isn't brutal. Oh, we're almost at the station. I'd say that was an efficient use of your time. Yeah, so would I. Now let me drink some water so my throat doesn't implode. I will be better by season 3. I'm just calling them seasons because it's like once a year I get to record, so I record as much as I can in one shot, so I make a new intro for it. I kinda need to because I only noticed recently that my Persona 5 intro is the only series that doesn't have a title card. How the fuck did I get this far in before I realized that? Oops. I just get breakfast, so now I'm hungry. I want something filling, but with summer coming up, I'm worried about having too many calories. Why don't we just get tea? The diner in Shibuya serves fruity tea. It smells good, it's great for your skin, and it totally increases your charm. Fruity tea? What a cute name! Sounds yummy! Being stylish starts from the inside out, after all, so I guess I'll try some.
Wow!
Fruity tea, huh? I don't think a hip drink that's real popular with the ladies. Do you want to try some? Do I look like a lady? Water's fine, you know. Nah, fuck it. Let's try some. That's delicious. That was lovely.
Nice.
No rule against dudes drinking it. If it tastes good and makes you more stylish, might as well, right? It might be a good idea to boost your charm by drinking fruity tea whenever you're at the diner. Yeah, true. I do like a cup of tea. I used to drink herbal tea when I used to work in the docks. I weirdly ran into one of my ex-workmates there.
Well,
more on that later. Open your textbooks. Today we'll be talking about records of the Three Kingdoms. Isn't it three houses? A variety of heroes battling for dominance. Truly an epic time.
Charismatic rulers and warlords with the command of 1,000 men may have their own appeal. But personally, I think that the strategists who supported them can't be ignored. Now then, Schwarzer-kun. In the book, Zhu Lang of Shu is famous for his exploits during the Battle of Red Cliff.
What is the answer?
But do you know what Chinese dish Zhu Lang is credited for inventing?
No, I do not know what Chinese dish Zhu Lang is credited for making. I doubt it is Mapo Tofu or Beefo Special, so I'm going to ask the audience. Well, I knew it wasn't Mapo Tofu. Bowsy, according to the internet. So, Bowsy?
Very good.
That's right. The answer is Bowsy. At the time, one region would use a person's head as an offering to quell an overflowing river. But Zhu Lang made a Bowsy in the shape of a head as a substitute. Well, we got it right. Is he really a delinquent or did he just Google that? He seems like a punk, but maybe he's actually serious about studying. Serious about studying. Yeah, that's what it is.
Nice going.
Wow, he must be really smart to be able to answer a question like that.
Mona, you saw me take out my phone and Google it.
Yep, dude, I'm real smart. I'm getting all choked up about it too.
Alright.
My knowledge improved, but it can't improve, but whatever. These days you can find Mao Zi with cute faces on them too. If you think about their origins, it's not too far off the mark.
Yep.
I never knew strategies came up with cooking and not just strategies. Suppose cooking is a strategic battle if you think about it. Go to our strategist. Let's see what she can cook up. Well, I suppose she can't be any worse than Yukiko used to be. Sure. I don't think she'd take too kindly to me asking her if she can cook me lunch though. I don't know. You don't know if you don't ask. But we are kind of avoiding it right now because all we've done recently is hang out with him. Speaking of hanging out, I really need to do something about my current situation. Which means I'm gonna go pick a fight with a fortune teller. Wish me luck, I'm gonna die. Where is my fortune teller, buddy? She's not here, is she? Nope, I need to be there at night. Okay, she be here? I mean, we did keep getting texts from her to hang out. So, yeah, why not? Now, I believe she was in the underground mall. She kept saying something about shopping, so I think it's a mall. I do think it's a... Well, I think everything's amusing to me. It's conversational. Someone just walked through me like I'm a ghost. Anyway. One of the biggest changes between last season and this season is the amount of posters up in my room. Because my brother's now moved temporarily out, so I now have the other half of my room back. So I've just stuck up more posters. So for instance, there's Alan Walker from The Grey Man up there. And I've got Miku... Not the normal Miku, which you're all thinking, oh, he's got more Hatsune Miku stuff, he's really obsessed. Yes, I'm obsessed, but no, it's not her. It is Miku from the Quintessential Quintuplets, which if you haven't seen, you have to see, because... You know the protagonist Yu Narukami from Persona 4? Him is the protagonist of this anime. Like, the entire anime is... Basically, also I'm not progressing the game, I'm just talking, is I guess episode 1 starts as the main character getting married to a sweet brunette woman, but you don't see her face, it's all from behind, and it refers to, if only we'd known this is what was going to, shortest saying to him, was going to happen when we got you to teach us, then it flashes all the way back to the high school when he taught her, along with her 4 identical sisters. So one of these 5 is the bride, but you don't know which one until the end. And even then, it's still up in the air. So maybe there's a season 2. But everyone already agrees that Miku is best girl. Because the internet is like me, and we like a redhead. So, we did it. We get Christina from fucking Steins Gate. Redhead, we like. Simple as that. That being said, Steins Gate has a lot of great girls. So, you know. I don't know why I've gone on this weird tangent. Oh, the other thing that changed since last time is I now have Mori-san's autograph in BlazBlue. Yeah, that's like my favourite autograph. And it was free. He's the best. We have a photo of him and me both posing like idiots in front of the camera, and we're professional game developers. I love my career. It's a good world. Sometimes. There's a lot of bad in it, don't get me wrong, but when there's good, it's good fun. We'll talk about that more when BlazBlue comes back on the air.
because it's more relevant now. Anyway, hi, Anne.
We'll just have to wait for now.
Guess now, while we wait, the suspense is seriously killing me.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, do you want to go somewhere? If you have time, I mean. Why not? We're not doing anything anyway. So what do you think? Spend some time with Anne? Yeah. Hey, Anne,
yeah.
Let me ask you something. If someone asks you to pay 100,000 yen for something, is that daylight robbery? Yeah, I thought that too. But if it turns out to just be a salt ball, now is that daylight robbery? And can I force feed the person who gave me it salt? That's a crime, huh? Okay. I hear what you're saying. So I meant to talk to her like an adult. I'll think about it. Anyway, so what should we do today? Let's have some tea.
Let's go!
Why don't we hang out at the diner then? I gotta go for a nice chat. I wanna try this herbal tea or the fruity tea that I heard about the other day. Or was it this morning? Recently. I like tea, okay? Everyone else dishes on it and says you should be drinking coffee, but I like tea, damn it. I'll just die for a while. It seems she's starting to gather her thoughts. Oh, that's right. That's something I might like. I should give it to her as a gift. Fuck it. Here's a flower basket. Here you go. This is for me? Yeah, because I need to get rid of this eventually, and I don't think you'd appreciate some roses. Cool, thanks. Guess this is mine now, huh? It seems like I didn't really impress that much with my gift for her. Well, don't offer me the object. I don't think my bond's not gonna deepen just yet, but that's not because I gave her the wrong thing. Don't worry, that's not why.
Thanks!
No worries.